career conversation, there should be multiple systematic process. One thing is you have to take notes of what role needs to be discussed rather than going very random idea, right? So career discussion is something sensitive to the other guy whom we are discussing with it, right? So we might miss out on certain factors, figures, statistics, or what kind of contribution he made in that particular scenario, all that, there are chances to miss. So it's important that you take notes on whatever he's conveying so that you have a point of view or perspective towards whether he's performed positively or negatively, right? Second thing is setting the agenda for meeting. Like, there should not be any overlapping on multiple discussions. It's going to be one particular topic, we have to stick with that, right? Whether it is a performance appraisal or anything planning or moving internally, whatever it is, the agenda should be set up so that we discuss about 5 to 10 points and then close it, you know, rather than discussing multiple things and then deviating to very many things and not coming to a conclusion. It becomes point blank, straightforward discussion on 5 to 10 points, close it. Third one is the practice element, because you should have a proper data when you are presenting something on the career front, right? So for that, you have to dig out more information on your current company, past company, on what you have really projected, performed in terms of quantitative aspects, right? So we cannot say I have performed well in last 3 months. Rather, you should mention I have closed 3 positions in 3 days. You know, that way you can perform and quantify it so that it makes sense in the discussion. You know, the most important factor in any career discussion is how you have saved 3 factors. One is the time, second is the cost, third is the effort. Right. So these 3 elements, whether if you have saved, that has to be quantified and has to be projected, because that's why you have been recruited. All right. So these elements you have to practice and say, without preparation, it is always little, you'll tend to get nervous if you are not prepared. But whether if you are prepared on what are the elements to talk, you have a clear vision and clarity on what you are going to project, and you yourself will feel confidence that, okay, you have done lot many things and I have lot many things to talk about and represented about. So that way, practice with your friends, practice with your colleagues, so that you don't miss out any point, because it's a one-time discussion and it is with your senior, right? You cannot just be very casual. So put it very professionally and to the point, close it, that will be more successful.